I want to talk about one of my favorite movies with you, Five Heartbeats. How did this movie find you, or did you go and find the movie?
Oh, the movie definitely found me.
Okay.
I didn't know anything about it, actually. Robert Townsend saw me, I didn't know him, saw me at the MTV Awards with Madonna.
Okay.
Originally, The Five Heartbeats was written by Robert Townsend and Keenan Ivory Wayans to play brothers. And it took a while to get made, and then, you know, Keenan got in Living Color. So Robert got to go after the brother, whatever brother he wanted.
Yeah.
So, and I met Robert, and it was an interesting situation for me.
Interesting how?
It was interesting because the way he was talking to me. He was talking to me in a way that no one had ever talked to me before. He pulled me around the corner, I think it was the Wilshire E. Bell Theater and stuff, and he was saying, you know, I see you as a black matinee idol. Someone that women will go to the movies for just because you're in the movies. You know,
check
same
out.
Way they do with the white guys. And I said, you do? When you're an actor in this town, you know, so much depends upon what people think of you. And even when you work, what someone thinks you work, everything's so subjective. You know, so to hear someone like Robert Townsend, who at the time he was coming off Hollywood Shuffle and was someone, you know,
so
we were looking forward to seeing doing some great things. For him to talk to me like that, I mean, unless he's a pimp. I mean, no one had really talked to me like that. I'm like, okay, really? I'm like, okay, that's what you see? Okay, I'm with it. Let's do it. You know, so, you know, that was the experience with Robin, and, you know, we've been super close ever since. Yeah.
Everyone that I've talked to about him always says a similar story, like he saw me in a different way or he spoke to me in a different way. Was working on set with Robert different from, like, other directors that you've worked with? And if so, how?
Well, working with Robert was different in a few ways. One, at that particular point, mostly all the directors I worked with were white.
Yeah.
So in that respect, it was different. But it was also different for me because I was a bit of a method actor. So, you know, I just stay in my role the entire time and like to live and breathe the role. And I was a little bit funny, to be honest with you, working with a guy who was also my director. You know, I didn't know how I was gonna be. You know, I was like, he's my brother in the movie, but he's also directing.
But I also gotta listen to him, yeah.
Yeah, you know, so it was weird, but I think after the long rehearsal process, which was like 6 or 7 weeks, that we went through, you know, I got used to it, and we just rolled from there.
I've always been fascinated by the idea of method acting, because I feel like whenever I hear about it, I only hear about like the extremes, like so-and-so like moved into a cave or something for a month to prepare for this. So what did method acting look like for this particular role? How did you prepare for it?
Preparing for The Five Heartbeats was, it was definitely different from when I did The Temptations or Little Richard or anything like that, because it's a fictional group. And, you know, so this is my role to make it what I want it to be. And, you know, I was very confident in the fact that, you know, I was right for this role. So for me, it was more about creating a character that was memorable, that wasn't like anyone else. I think all the characters were like that in the movie. I think that's the reason why people went around thinking the Five Heartbeats is a real group.
I thought it was a real group for a really long
time. Someone told me that they found that the Five Heartbeats wasn't a real group, and they weren't that upset since they found that there was no Santa Claus.
I believe it. I believe it, absolutely. So to that note, I want to switch directions nearly completely to another movie that you did that all 90s kids love, Cool Runnings. I did not know that that was a real story, again, until like I was much, much older.
You know, I lived in Jamaica, St. Anne's Bay, probably 3 to 4 months out of the year for 10 years.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so when they went scouting for School Runnings, the late Dawn Steele, when they came back and they called me in to Disney for a meeting, they were like, what is it with you in Jamaica? Everywhere we go, they say, Leon has to be in the movie. It's our favorite guy. So, you know, she was like, yeah, they just love you. I said, well, that's where I go after every movie.
How did you go about both making this role yours, but also staying true to the character that you portrayed?
You know, for me, it's the most important thing is to bring the character to life. Mm-hmm. You know, take a writer's words and make that character real. Mm-hmm. You know, and I think I remember something in the LA Times reviewing Cool Runnings and said that that I made my character so real that he felt as though he was sitting right next to you sometimes. Mm. And to me, that's like that was a high praise to
me. Yeah, what a compliment.
Because I'm, you know, for me, that's my job. My job is to make that character real. Mm-hmm. You know, and so when I was preparing for Cool Runnings, if you saw my room, there was like every sprinter there was, you know, and I try to match my body up against theirs and, you know, make sure that I look like I could be a runner, because the beginning of a story, especially when you play the lead character in a movie, if you can convince people that you are that person from the very beginning, you can take them anywhere. You can even take them to Mars and they'll believe you.
I mean,
as long as they believe you are that person.
I would follow you to Mars. I would, just decided, absolutely. You were in a little movie called Above the Rim. RIP to Tupac, RIP to Bernie Mac. What do you think you in particular brought to such a varied cast?
Well, for one thing, you know, I don't ever like to talk about anything that I've done that's is any better than anyone else. But in talking about Above the Rim, I do like to say that I believe that for ball players, that's the best movie.
Ever. Because best ball movie, period.
Well, no, because everyone in there were ballers. I mean, those guys you saw in the street, those are all like schoolyard legends from the Rucker.
Yeah.
Our practices for the roles like that, those scrimmages at NYU were great. Dwayne Martin, you know, was one of the last guys cut from the Knicks. I mean,
I did not know that.
Yeah, I mean, he could really ball.
Wow.
And, you know, I was all cities, you know, scoring New York and everything when I was in high school. So, I mean, it was real ball. And so I like to say that one of the things that I brought to the role was obviously the experience of being a real ball player. And that same park that we played in, I averaged 30 points a game, you know, when I was in high school.
Really?
So it was,
you were at home pretty much.
Everything was very familiar to me. But on the flip side, you know, that's a character.
Yeah.
You know, Thomas Shepard is a character, and I played the character. Even the way I play basketball in that movie is not the way I play, per se. That's the way I thought my character would play.
I am legally obligated to talk to you about The Temptations. Legally obligated. If I don't do it, I get ushered out immediately. We don't want to see that happen. So, one of your most iconic lines, as everyone knows, I've been practicing this line for my whole life, maybe, give or take 10 years.
Okay, go ahead.
Let me have it. Take me to dinner first or something. I would actually like to challenge you to an Otis off, to an Ain't Nobody Coming to See You Otis off.
But you, that's not fair.
How not? How is it not?
Because, one, that role I played a long time ago.
Okay.
I don't really watch my movies. I don't like to, because after a while I start picking myself apart. You know, I'm like, why you hold your head like that? Why your lips, look funny?
I do the same thing.
You know, I don't even want to do that. I'll just leave it alone. People love it. You watch the movie all the time. You say the line all the time.
You're right.
So you have a distinct advantage over me.
I'm also not a professional actor, though. I feel like that works against me much more.
But I can tell you something that's more important.
What's that?
The history of the line.
Expound. What do you mean?
Well, that line wasn't in the script.
What?
No.
It wasn't in the script?
No.
It was improvised?
Yep.
What?
We were in rehearsals, and, you know, I was there rough it the entire time, okay? And I found out later my co-stars didn't particularly care for me. but I stayed in that role the entire time, and so I was always, you know, thinking of things and telling the director and the producers and stuff, and things that I had researched and the way things were. And and actually, I just said that line in rehearsal. And Alan Arkush came and whispered in my ear and said, you know, he doesn't really like it when you say that. And I turned to him and said, he's not supposed to.
Fair point.
Did you see the reaction on his face when I said it? I said, isn't that what you want? So.
And that was that.
I just improvise a line, and next thing I know, it's like that line follows me around the world.
Instead of a challenge that I still feel like I would lose, maybe you can be my acting coach for like a second. I will deliver the line for you. You let me know how I do.
Okay.
Is that fair?
Sure.
Okay, and don't hold back just because I'm very charming and fragile, like a, you know, flower. Am I like a flower?
Okay, flower.
Okay, get in my zone. Okay. Action. Ain't nobody coming to see you, Otis. End scene.
Really good.
Are you just saying that because I'm very charming?
No.
Yay!
I'm saying that because you got the most important thing.
What was that?
About it, not the words, your lips.
I'm so glad.
They was all out here like.
I was like, he's bad. He means that for real. Oh, yay. Well, I'm in the wrong field. I quit, everybody. I'm an actress now, so.
You obviously paid your cable bill.
Well, we ain't gotta talk about my finances at the moment.